Dear classic Mercedes owners, this is Ivica speaking. And in this video, as I promised, we're going to be talking about the sensor potentiometer. Well, what do we have to say about this part? If you have a car that has more than 150k kilometers on the clock, then consider checking this part. This is one of the parts that you should check. Well, how do you check this part? You know, just take your OBD scanner and ask your ECU. If you don't know how to do that, I have a link here if you want to see that video about the OBD scanner. Well, the purpose of this video was to tell you how to do some things right way and not like me to go around and checking this or that, or maybe it's this part, maybe it's that part. No, just go to your ECU, ask him, hey, how's doing, man? Everything okay? And if he gives you one impulse only, then he will say, well, it's fine with me. I think you still love me, and so on, etc. Well, but if you get four impulses out of your computer, then you must know that this part, the sensor potentiometer, is bad. Well, how do you check this part? Now we're going to see. And now I would like to share something with you. Something about checking the potentiometer. How do you check it with a multimeter? So it was the instruction that says that you have to measure contacts 1 and 2 and you should get the nominal value. Let me show you. Here, contact one, the contact two, sorry, it's a bit, here we get nothing. Well, it's not contact one and two, but one and three. Don't worry about that if this is the contact one should be negative or positive. Here what you have, this is your protection against bad measuring. But look now what happens. I will now measure the resistance between the contacts 1 and 3. Let me show you. Look now what we get. Now we get the nominal value of 4.2 kilo ohms. How much it should be. You see? And the second step. Okay, I was measuring here ohms. You can, if you have a cheaper multimeter, set it to 20 ohms. And it's okay. And in the second step, you're going to measure the contacts 1 and 2. You're going to deflect the sensor plate. And as you deflect it, the resistance must rise continuously without falling down up to 2/3.
not up to a half, but up to 2/3 of the value, and then should come down. Well, that's it.
Now, why did I choose this potentiometer? I chose it from eBay, from the guy from Germany, and I will put the link in the description below. The guy advertises himself on eBay as Joshworld. His name is Jonas Schwind. He is from Germany, from Darmstadt. And making these potentiometers is his only facility. Well, the part is very cheap, and it looks like the original one. Just this part here is not as white as the OEM part, and this orange part is a bit darker, and not just like these Chinese copies that are fully black. That's the first reason why I decided to buy that potentiometer. The next one, because it's top German quality, and the guy is sincere. The price is cheap, and now you get, of course, you get it with rubber sealant and with eyelets. This part, it is called the eyelets. You get the detailed instructions with pictures. You will get it in you will get it in English and in your mother language. It's going to be a Google Translate version, but no matter. Okay, then you get detailed instructions with pictures, you get a bill, you get full right to ship it back in, and you get 5 years warrant. The man says that the part is not OEM, but it's a quality aftermarket part. The description: it's a common problem with KE-Jetronic that after many years the part wears out, and it leads to rapid changes in a signal at tiny movements of the sensor plate. The consequences? Unsteady, jerky, idle, up to engine shakings, starting problems, power loss, and engine stalling. In these cases, the only thing left for you is the replacement. Don't do it at the dealership, because they are going to tell you that they don't sell you just this part, the potentiometer itself, but they will have to change you the whole airflow sensor potentiometer. The price? don't ask about it how much. The part is compatible with original numbers and fits in M102, 103, 116, 117 engines. And those are chassis W124, 126, 201, R107, R129, W461 and W463. And this part is one of the key components for steady idle. It's not the only component, of course. There are more of them. And here in the next video, we're going to be talking about the steady idle at KE-Jetronic. There are many components that should be checked if you want to get steady idle. But this is one of them. For example, if you wake up in the morning, you want to go to work, you start your car, the car starts fine, it raises the RPM up to 1200, and as the ICV does its job, the engine stalls. Well, then I can tell you that you have a bad sensor potentiometer. It's for sure that you have a bad sensor potentiometer. If you liked this video, then please like it, share it, comment it, and if you happen to subscribe to the channel,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
And till the next video, happy Mercedes.
Have a great day.